Hi, Professor Groundlin here. Let's learn how to stain bacteria. I am sure that you're already aware that bacteria are very small, so you understand we'll need to use a very good microscope to see them. If you have taken a biology course before, you probably looked at human cells under the microscope. For our cells, a total magnification of 400 times allows you to easily see your individual cells. But bacteria are tiny compared to your cells. We're going to use oil immersion lens to get a magnification of 1,000 times, and they'll still seem pretty small. The other thing about bacterial cells is that they're generally transparent, so you'll need to stain them before you can view them. In most biology courses, the very first stain you do is a simple stain. During this lab, you learn several important things. First, how to make a bacterial smear. This is a preparation step that's used in almost all the rest of the staining procedures you will learn. Second, how to stain cells. Third, how to use the oil immersion lens. And fourth, how to classify bacteria based on their cell shape and arrangement. True to its name, a simple stain is a very easy staining procedure. It involves just one staining solution. As a little bit of background here, the surface of a bacterium is slightly negatively charged, so any basic dye, such as methylene blue, crystal violet, safranin, can all be used to stain the bacteria because these basic dyes have positively charged dye particles. Note that there's also acidic dyes, such as Congo red. These have negative charges, and they can be used to stain the background around the cells. Those stains are used, for example, in capsule stains. In preparation for staining, a smear will need to be made first. Basically, what you're doing here is transferring bacteria to a slide, letting them dry, and then heat fixing them. Heat fixing does two things. It kills the bacteria, and it sticks them to the slide. Here's the procedure for making that smear. If you're working from a broth culture, first you'll agitate the broth to suspend the bacteria. Then sterilize your inoculating loop and aseptically transfer 2 to 3 loops full of bacteria to a clean slide. If you're working from a solid culture, a plate or a slant, first put a very small drop of sterile water on the clean slide, then using a sterilized inoculating loop, aseptically transfer a very small amount of bacteria into the water and disperse them well. Whether you were working from a broth culture or an agar culture, you should now see a thin, even film, the area about the size of a dime on your slide. You'll need to allow that to thoroughly air dry. You'll know it's dry when it takes on an opaque look. Next, you're going to heat fix that smear by passing the underside of the slide through a Bunsen burner flame a few times. This is the step that really takes some practice. If you don't heat fix it enough, the bacteria will not stick to the slide and they'll be washed off during the staining procedure. But if you overheat fix, the bacteria will shrink and take on really weird shapes. Now for the actual staining. Cover the smear with your basic dye. I'm using methyl blue today. Allow that dye to remain on the smear for 1 to 2 minutes. Next, using distilled water, gently wash off the excess stain from the slide by directing a gentle stream over the surfaces. Tap off excess water and gently blot dry with bilboes paper. Now place the stained smear on the microscope stage, bactericide up, and view on the oil immersion. As a refresher, When using the microscope, always start on the 4x or 10x objective. Start with the stage all the way up and use the coarse objective knob to slowly lower the stage until the specimen is in view. Then use the fine focus and choose an area of the smear in which the cells are well spread out into a single layer. Center that area in your field of view and rotate to the 40x objective. Use the fine focus to sharpen the image. Rotate the head and apply the oil immersion directly to the smear. And now focus the smear under oil immersion. Individual cells should be present. Although bacteria can grow an amazing variety of shapes, typically a species will have a shape that's genetically determined. Three common shapes are bacillus, coccus, and spiral. So the first thing you want to do when you've focused your microscope is determine that cell shape. This is also referred to as cell morphology. Next, you'll want to determine the arrangement. Although bacteria are single-celled organisms, sometimes when they reproduce, the bacteria will remain attached to each other. To indicate the arrangement, you'll want to add a prefix to the cell shape. Some common prefixes are diplo, strepto, and staphylo. So there you have it. That's easy. What could possibly go wrong? Well, I'm glad you asked. Here's some common errors. If you look under that microscope and there was no bacteria or very few bacteria on the slide, think about this. If you were working from a broth culture, did you remember to agitate the tube before you got your sample? Did you remember to properly heat fix the slide? Under heat fixing does not allow bacteria to adhere to the slide. If you look under that microscope and you can't see a monolayer of bacteria, so you can't see individual cell shapes, there's too many bacteria on the slide. If you were working from an auger, you probably took too large of a sample. Or perhaps you forgot to put the water on the slide or just didn't disperse the bacteria in the water very well. The other thing that could have happened was too much dye left on the slide, meaning that you didn't rinse both sides of the slide very well. Two other errors to mention. If you put a large drop of water on that slide when you're working from an auger, you're going to have to wait an annoyingly long time for it to dry. And if you look under that microscope and the cells look all shrunken and their shape is really weird, you've probably overheat fixed. Well, that's it for now. I hope that your stains come out picture perfect.